Hello students, I am Manoj Kundare, the assistant professor of electronic science. Welcome back to our e-learning platform. In previous video, we have seen the concept of different types of the computer networks. The link of the previous video is available in the description box. Please check it. Now, in this video, we are going to see the concept of the network topology. A network topology is the arrangement with which the computer systems or network devices are connected to each other. We know that in a computer network, there are the number of computers connected with each other. The way in which these computers are connected with each other is known as the network topology. I hope you all understand the basic idea about the network topology. Now, the topologies may define both physical and logical aspect of the network. Both logical and physical topologies could be same or different in a same network. There are different types of network topologies depending upon their connections. Some of them are the point-to-point topology, bus topology, ring topology, star topology, tree topology, mesh topology, and hybrid topology. Let's see the details about each type one by one. The first one is the point-to-point network topology. As the name implies, this topology is established between the two points, that means the two computers, hence it is named as the point-to-point topology. Point-to-point topology is the easiest of all the network topologies. In this method, the network consists of a direct link between two computers or two hosts. That means in a point-to-point topology, there is a direct link between the two points, that means the two computers. And hence, it is a very simple network topology. It is also the easiest network topology. Let's see the advantages of this topology. The first one is, this is faster and highly reliable than other types of connections since there is a direct connection. In this topology, there is no need for a network operating system. It does not need an expensive server as individual workstations are used to access the files. In this topology, there is no need for dedicated network technicians because each user sets their permissions. That means, in short, we can say that in this type of topology, there is a direct link between the two computers, hence the data transmission is very fast and highly reliable. Due to the direct link, there is no need of the separate network operating system or the server. Also, due to the direct connection, there is no need of special technicians to handle these connections. I hope you all understand the advantages of point-to-point network topology. Now, let's see the disadvantages of this network topology. The first one is, the biggest drawback is that it can only be used for the small areas where the computers are in closed proximity. This is the biggest disadvantages of the point-to-point network topology. That means if we use the large network system, then we can't use the point-to-point network topology. Also, we can't backup the files and folders centrally. There is no security besides the permissions. Users often do not require to log onto their workstations. These are the disadvantages of the point-to-point network topology. Now, let's see the next type of topology named as the bus topology. As the name implies, the bus topology consists of a separate wire or a line which acts as the bus or trunk, and the different computers are connected with this bus through the multiple lines. That means in bus topology, all our data transfer or the operation perform on this bus only, hence named as the bus topology. Let's see the other details of bus topology, such as the bus topology uses a single cable or trunk which connects all the included computers or networks like this. The main cable acts as the spine for the entire network. When it has exactly two endpoints, then it is called as linear bus topology. I hope you all understand the basic idea about the bus topology. Here is, we elaborate the concept of the bus topology. In this diagram, we can see here that these three computers, printers, server, or internet, these are all connected with a single bus. All the data transmission is performed through this bus only. Okay, I hope now you all get the clear idea about the bus topology. Okay, now let's see the advantages of the bus topology. The first one is that the cost of the cable is very less compared to the other topologies. So it is widely used to build small networks. That means for small network, the bus topology is highly preferable. The second advantage is that the famous for LAN network because they are inexpensive and easy to install. It is widely used when a network installation is small, simple, or temporary. It is one of the passive technologies. That means it is the one of the passive topologies. So computers on the bus only listen for the data being sent that are not responsible for moving the data from one computer to the other computer. These are the advantages of the bus topology. Now let's see the disadvantages of the bus topology, such that in case if a common cable fails, then the entire system will crash down. That means if this bus fails, then there is no connection between the computers or no any operation can be performed during the failure of this bus. When network traffic is heavy, it develops collisions in the network. That means when all the computers try to send or receive the data simultaneously or continuously, then the network traffic across the bus becomes heavy, due to which the collision may occur. Whenever network traffic is heavy or the nodes are too many, the performance time of the network significantly decreases. Cables are always of a limited length. These are the disadvantages of the bus topology. I hope you all understand the basic idea about the bus topology. Now let's consider the next type, known as the ring topology. The ring topology is called as because it forms a ring as each computer is connected to the other computer, with last one connected to the first. Here, if this is the first computer, then this is connected to the second computer connected with third computer connected with the fourth, and fourth connected with the first. Hence, it completes a ring. Hence, it is known as the ring topology. In this ring topology, there is exactly two neighbors for each device. That means for this computer, it has the two neighbors, computer second, computer four. Similarly, computer three has also two neighbors, computer two and computer four, and so on. Okay, I hope you all understand the ring topology. In ring topology, the transmission is unidirectional. That means the transmission can be happen or can be performed in only one direction only. Okay, now this is the basic idea about ring topology, in which the four computers 1, 2, 3, 4 are connected. The data packet move from computer 1 to 2, then computer 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. It completes a ring. Hence it is called as the computers in ring topology. Okay, now let's see the advantages of the ring topology, such that first one is, it is easy to install and reconfigure. Adding or deleting a device in a ring topology needs you to move only two connections. That means if we want to add another computer in the system, then we have to connect this computer with this and this computer. Then we can make the ring of five computers. The connection is very simple. It offers equal access to all the computers of the networks. It has the faster error checking and acknowledgement. These are the advantages of the ring topology. Now, let's consider the disadvantages of the ring topology. The first one is the unidirectional traffic. As discussed earlier, in ring topology, the data transfer or the work is performed only in only one direction. Okay, this is the major drawback of this topology. The second one is break in a single ring can risk the breaking of entire network. That means if the connection between these two computers is disconnected or destroyed, then the total ring is destroyed and we cannot perform our operations. Okay, modern days high speed LANs made this technology less popular. In ring topology, signals are circulating all the times, which develops unwanted power consumption. That means in this topology, the signals are continuously travel in circular path. This causes the unwanted power consumption in the circuit. It is very difficult to troubleshoot the ring network. Adding or removing the computers can disturb the other network activity. These are the disadvantages of the ring topology. Now, let's consider the next type of topology named as the star topology. In this type of topology, all the computers are connected to a single hub through a cable. This is a hub and all the computers are connected with the hub through a cable. That means, in short, we can say that the hub is connected with this computer and this type of connection is known as the point-to-point connection. Okay? This hub is a central node and all other nodes are connected to the central node. That is, there exists a point-to-point connection between host and hub. I hope you all understand the basic idea about the star topology. Here, in this diagram, we can see here that this computer is connected with this hub. Similarly, all these computers are connected with this hub through a separate line. The server is also connected with the hub through a separate line. This type of connection is known as the star topology. Okay? Now, let's see the advantages of the star topology. The first one is, it is easy to troubleshoot, set up and modify. Only those nodes are affected that has failed, other nodes still work. That means, if this node is failed to perform its operation, then at the same time, all other nodes can perform their task. Okay? Because there is a separate point-to-point connection between a central node, that means a hub, and the other peripheral nodes. I hope you all understand the concept. It has the fast performance with few nodes and very low network traffic. In star topology, addition, deletion, and moving of the device are easy. Now, let's see the disadvantages of the star topology such that the first one is, if the hub or concentrator fails, nodes are disabled. That means if the central hub is fail or destroyed, then all the connections are failed, due to which this topology is breakdown. Okay, cost of the installation of star topology is costly. Heavy network traffic can sometimes slow the bus considerably. Performance depends on the hub's capacity. A damaged cable or lack of proper transmission or termination may bring the network down. These are the disadvantages of the star topology. Now, let's see the next type of topology named as the tree topology. As the name implies, it structures like an tree. Okay, it has the root node and all other nodes are connected to it to forming a hierarchy. This is the root node and all other nodes are connected to it. This creates the hierarchy. I hope you all understand the concept here. It is also called as the hierarchical topology. It should at least have three levels to the hierarchy. This is the first level, second level, and this is the third level. At least it requires the three levels to make the hierarchical topology. Okay, in this diagram we can see here that this is the central node or the root node, and to this node all other nodes are connected. This diagram elaborates the idea about the tree topology. I hope you all now understand the concept here. Now let's see the advantages of the tree topology. The first one is failure of one node never affects the rest of the network. The node expansion is fast and easy. Detection of error is easy in process, and it is easy to manage and maintain. These are the advantages of tree topology. There are some disadvantages of tree topology, such that it is heavily cabled topology. That means to form the tree topology we require a heavy number of cables. If more nodes are added, then maintenance is difficult. If the hub or concentrator fails, attached nodes are also disabled. That means if the root node is failed, then the other rest system also fails. This is the disadvantage of the tree topology. Now let's see the next type of topology, named as the mesh topology. The mesh topology has a unique network design in which each computer on the network connects to every other. That means in this diagram we can see here that this computer is connected with this computer, this computer, this computer, and this computer. Similarly, all the computers are connected with the remaining computer through a separate line. Okay, this type of connection is known as the mesh topology. It develops a point-to-point connection between all the devices of the network. It offers high level of redundancy, so even if one network cable fails, still data has an alternative path to reach its destination. That means if we want to transmit data from this computer to this computer, and in this case if this path fails, then we can transfer data through this computer like this. This computer transfer data towards this computer, and again this computer transfers data towards the destination. That means in mesh topology there are number of alternative paths present. I hope you all understand. Let's see this diagram. In this diagram we can see here that this computer or each computer is connected with the other computers through a separate line, and the data transfers through a separate lines. I hope you all understand the basic idea of the mesh topology. Okay, now let's see the types of mesh topology. Mainly there are two types of mesh topology. The first one is partial mesh topology and full mesh topology. Up till now we are going to see or we seen the full mesh topology. Now let's see what is meant by the partial mesh topology. In this type of topology, most of the devices are connected almost similarly as full topology. The only difference is that few devices are connected with just two or three devices. That means in this diagram we can see here that in this diagram there is no separate connection between each computer like that. Okay, I hope you all understand the partial mesh topology. Let's see once again the full mesh topology. In this topology, every node or device are directly connected with each other. Okay, now let's see the advantages of the mesh topology. The first one is the network can be expanded without disturbing the current users. Dedicated links helps to eliminate the traffic problem. No traffic problem as nodes has dedicated or separate links. It has multiple links So if any single route is blocked, then other routes should be used for the data communication. The point-to-point links makes the fault identification isolation process easy. It helps you to avoid the chances of network failure by connecting all the system to a central nodes. These are the advantages of mesh technology. Now let's see the disadvantages of the mesh technology. The first one is the installation is complex because every node is connected to every node. Okay, a mesh topology is robust. Every system has its privacy and security. It is expensive due to use of more cables. That means if there are number of PCs or computers are large, then the cables or the wires required to connect them with each other are also more. Okay, this increases the entire cost of the system. The no proper of utilization of system. It requires more space for dedicated links or separate links. Because of the amount of cabling and the number of input outputs, it is expensive to implement. It requires large space to run the cables. These are the disadvantages of mesh topology. Now, let's see the next type of topology known as the daisy chain topology. Before going to see the daisy chain network topology, we have to remember the ring topology. In ring topology, we seen that the four computers are connected with each other like that. Okay, that means the computer first is connected to computer second, second is connected with the third, third is connected with the four, and four is connected with the one. Here, the fourth computer, that means last computer, is connected with the first computer, hence it creates a ring. Hence, we named it as the ring topology. But in daisy chain topology, the fourth computer, that means the last computer, is not connected with the first computer. If such type of arrangement is done, then it is known as the daisy chain topology. Okay, let's see the details about it. Then, this topology connects all the hosts in a linear fashion. That means the four computers are connected linearly with each other. Similar to the ring topology, all hosts are connected to two hosts only, except the end host. That means the fourth computer is not connected with the first computer. Okay? Means if the end host in the daisy chain are connected, then it represents the ring topology. Let's see the advantages of the ring top daisy chain topology, such that no use of extra cables, data transmission is reliable and faster and easier. It is cheap in terms of construction. The disadvantage of daisy chain topology is that if a number of nodes increases in the network, it can slow down the whole network. Okay. Now, let's see the last type of network topology named as the hybrid topology. The hybrid topology combines two or more topologies. You can see in this architecture in such a manner that the resulting network does not exhibit one of the standard topology. That means in this diagram we can see here that there is no one standard topology. That means there is a three network connection. This is a star network. This is the star network, and this also a star network. These three star networks are connected in ring with each other. Okay, hence it is known as the hybrid network topology. The combining topologies may contain attributes of star, ring, bus, and daisy chain topologies. Internet is the best example of the largest hybrid topology. I hope you all understand the basic idea about the network topology. In this animation, we can also see here that the two star topologies are connected with the single bus or the bus topology. Okay, I hope you all understand the concept of the hybrid technology topology. In hybrid topology, There is no single topology is used. There is a combination of different topologies. Now, let's see the advantages of the hybrid topology. The first one is it offers the easiest method for error detection and troubleshooting. It is highly effective and flexible networking topology. It is scalable, so you can increase your network size. The disadvantage of hybrid topology is that the design of hybrid topology is complex. It is one of the costliest network topology. I hope you all understand all the network topologies used in the network or the computer network. Thank you.